Okay, good afternoon to everyone. So today I will discuss to you the history of the correctional facilities under the Bureau of Correction, the existing prisons and the penal farms of the Bureau of Correction. First is the old Bilibid prison. Okay, the old Bilibid prison is what we call the Manila City Jail ngayon. Okay, so the first penal institution in the country whose scope is a national penitentiary in nature. Okay, it was constructed in 1847 in the Bilibid district in Manila. Okay, the prison facility was initially named Carcel y Presidio Correctional, which housed about during that time is more than 1,000 prisoners or 1,127 prisoners all over the Philippines. Okay. And it was also established even before the effectivity of the Spanish Penal Code. It was enacted 17 years before in 1870 and took effect on September 4, 1884. And it enforceable in the Philippine Islands on March 13, 1887. Okay, so the old Bilibid prison was located at Azcaraga, Manila, at the back of what is today the Central Market along the Quezon Boulevard. Okay, but while the Bilibid prison was already in operation in 1847, it was only recognized and formally designated as an insular penitentiary, okay, through a royal decree issued some 18 years later in 1865. And the physical layout of the old Bilibid prison or the Bilibid prison was constructed in conformity with the dominant concept of criminology existing in Europe during those time. Okay, custody, security on confinement. So the cells in the Bilibid prison was constructed in radial shape similar. Okay, yung pabilog, yung parang mga may spoke wheel. Okay, so a central commanding tower was erected at the center. Meron siyang central commanding tower doon sa gitna of the spoke type of that or the spoke type construction of the Bilibid for easy control of prisoners, especially in times of disturbances kagaya ng riots. Okay, so in this tower the officer of the day exercised command and supervision of the facility. So yung mga building sa Bilibid prison ay tinawag na brigadas. Okay? Eh diyan galing yung salitang brigadas, the Spanish word use. Okay, sa mga building. Okay? So next is the San Ramon Prisons and Penal Farm. Okay? 20 years after the establishment of the Bilibid Insular Penitentiary, the San Ramon Prisons and Penal Farm was also constructed in 1869 and it was operated on August 21, 1870. That was in the southern tip of Zamboanga Peninsula, malapit sa Zamboanga City. And this San Ramon Prisons and Penal Farm was originally intended for the confinement of convicted Moro insurrectos. Okay? Sila yung mga lumalaban sa mga Spanish noon. Okay. And also ginagamit din yung Zamboanga Peninsula para sa as a banishment site for political nonconformists. Okay? Nagaling dito sa Luzon at Visayas kaya doon ipinatapon si Jose Rizal sa may Dapitan. Kasi sila yung mga lumalaban for the reforms dito sa atin. Okay, sila yung mga lumalaban sa mga Espanyol noon. So ang San Ramon and the San Ramon prisons and the penal farm was named in memory of its founder. Ang kanyang founder ay si Ramon Blanco, a Spanish captain in the Royal Army. Okay, and this San Ramon prisons and the penal farm was closed during the Spanish-American War. Nung nagkagulo na yung Amerika at ang Espanyol dito sa Pilipinas, naipasara yung San Ramon prisons and the penal farm. Okay? Noong 1898, and it was reopened in 1904 nung nanalo yung mga Amerikano. Kaya nakuha nila yung Pilipinas sa kamay ng Espanya. And under the American regime, the Bureau of Prisons was created under the Reorganization Act of 1905, or the Act number 1407 on November 1, 1905, as an agency under the Department of Commerce and Police. Okay, so the San Ramon Prisons at Pendle Farm has an aggregate area of more than 1,000 hectares, 1,524 hectares, okay, and was made productive through the blood and sweat of the tears of the prisoners who passed the portals of the penal institution. And today, the San Ramon Prisons and Penal Farm, their main crop or the principal product of San Ramon Prison is copra, which is one of the biggest sources of income of the Bureau of Prisons. Okay, and in January 1, 1915, the San Ramon Prison was placed under the auspices of the Bureau of Prisons and started receiving prisoners from Mindanao. Okay, yung Bureau of Prisons natin ay nabuo during the American regime by virtue of Reorganization Act of 1905, or the Act number 1407 on November 1, 1905, as an agency under the Department of Commerce and Police. So it was later on the jurisdiction was assigned to the Department of Commerce and Public Instruction, the predecessor of the Department of Education, and finally it nestled under the wings of the Department of Justice hanggang ngayon. Yan yung kwento ng Bureau of Prison. Okay, next is the Iwahig Penal Colony. The Iwahig Penal Colony, also known as the Luhit Penal Settlement in Puerto Princesa, okay, was established on the orders of Governor Forbes. Okay, dito sa Iwahig Penal Colony, okay, it was built during the American period on November 16, 1904. And dito ikinukulong yung mga incorrigible prisoners, okay, yung mga hindi, yung parang hindi na mare-rehabilitate, sa tingin ng mga Amerikano ay hindi na mare-rehabilitate. Okay. So ito yung isa sa pinakabaluwang na prison farms under the Bureau of Prison and under executive order 67, or yung EO 67 natin, okay, the land area of the Iwahig Penal Colony was expanded to 41,007 hectares. Okay, issued by Governor Newton Gilbert on October 15, 1912. So dito nagsimula yung salitang prison without wall. It was from this facility that the term prison without wall was has its beginning. Okay, because today this penal institution is considered as one of the most open penal institution in the world. Okay, kasi isla yung Iwahig Penal Colony. So in the Iwahig Penal Colony, it was divided into sub-colonies. So there are 4 sub-colonies of the Iwahig Penal Colony. Ito yung Santa Lucia, Inagawan, Montible, and Central. Okay. So each sub-colony as an autonomous institution under the management of a penal supervisor. May kanya-kanyang penal supervisor ang mga sub-colonies na ito. Ngayon, dahil sa luwang ng Iwahig Penal Colony, meron silang hiniwalay na lupa na kung saan ito ay dinidistribute nila sa mga nakatapos na ng sintensya na mga prisoner na ayaw nang bumalik sa kanilang mga lugar. Ito yung tinatawag nilang tagumpay settlement. So it's released prisoner prisoner award is given as 6 hectares farm lot as a homestead. Yung mga ayaw lang umuwi sa kanilang mga pamilya at sa kanilang mga lugar. Okay. So under the Reorganization Act of 1407, it was passed into law mandating the Philippine Commission to create the Bureau of Prison under the Department of Commerce and the Police. One of the first act of the Bureau upon its creation is to reverse the status of Iwahig Penal Colony as a destination for maximum security incorrigible prison. Ito yung isang purpose kung bakit nabuo yung Reorganization Act of 1407. And the Act of 1905, the Bureau of Prison was created under the Department of Commerce and Police, and later it was transferred under the Public to the Department of Public Instruction, and finally under the Department of Justice. Okay. So another correctional institution na naipatayo is yung Correctional Institution for Women. Okay? So naipatayo ang Correctional Institution for Women or yung CIW para ma-separate yung mga babae. Okay? So naipatayo yung CIW because of Republic Act 3579 noong November 27, 1929. This law was passed, okay, to establish the Correctional Institution for Women. Okay, the Penal Institution for Women was constructed on an 18 hectare of land in what is now the Mandaluyong City. Kaya matatagpuan, makikita natin yung CIW sa may Mandaluyong City. Okay. And in 1934, the position of female superintendent was created to superintend the operation of the facility. So noong 1934, nagtalaga na sila ng mga ng babae na mamumuno sa CIW. Okay? So pero hindi naman lahat ng babae ay hindi naman lahat ng mga nagtatrabaho sa CIW ay babae. Kailangan din nila ng mga lalaki for their perimeter security. Okay? So ngayon, the Correctional Institution for Women is run entirely by female personnel with the exception of the perimeter guards na mga lalaki. So yan yung CIW. Okay. So next is the New Bilibid Prison. Okay. The New Bilibid Prison was established and constructed by virtue of Proclamation 414 in 1931. Okay, as an enabling order to the Commonwealth Act number 3732, also the official basis for the reopening or for the opening of the Davao Penal Colony in the island of Mindanao. Okay, the New Bilibid Prison in Muntinlupa is the main insular penitentiary designed to house the prison population of the Philippines. And it is maintained by the Bureau of Correction under the Department of Justice. Okay. Yung land area ng New Bilibid Prison is 551 hectares. Okay. But 104 hectares of the facility was transferred to the housing project of the Department of Justice. Okay, in the New Bilibid Prison, there are three security camps. Okay, we have the maximum security compound. We have the medium security compound na kung saan yun yung tinatawag nilang Camp Sampagit, Camp Sampagita, where the youth rehabilitation for juvenile offenders and also situated on the Camp Sampagita and also the reception and diagnostic center. At yung pinakahuling security camp ng NBP is the minimum security compound na makita na makikita sa bukang sa Camp Bukang Liwayway. Okay? Bakit pinangalan ng Bukang Liwayway? Because the name Bukang Liwayway is implying, okay? Implying the coming release of prisoners, listing yung mga malapit ng makalabas, 6 months na lang makakalabas na, yung mga matatanda na doon nilalagay sa may minimum security camp, yung mga tinatawag nilang mga trustee, yung mga mapagkakatiwalaang mga preso. Okay. Doon naman kasi sa medium security compound, it houses the medium security prisoners na yung kanilang mga sentensya is below 20 years. Okay. As computed from the minimum sentence per classification interpretation. And those classified for colony assignment, doon nakalagay doon sa medium security compound and also the youth rehabilitation center for the youthful offender. Okay, doon naman sa reception and the diagnostic center, nabuo yan because of the administrative order number 8 series of 1953 of the Department of Justice. Okay, so the reception and the diagnostic center, presently known as the inmate reception and education center, yan ang bagong tawag ngayon, inmate reception and education center. Okay, this is a prison facility within the medium security compound of the New Bilibid Prison. Sila yung mga tumatanggap ng mga bagong salta, mga newly committed national male prisoners coming and it is the entry point of all incoming prisoners who will be subjected to classification and distribution to the operating institution. Kasi andyan yung mga classification board and kina-classify kung sa maximum, sa medium, okay, o kung saan siya dadalhin. Diyan sa may inmate reception and education center. Okay, but currently it has been charged with the responsibility of providing education and the training of inmates at the medium security compound of the New Bilibid Prison. Okay. Ito the first RDC was created in the building 9 of the maximum security compound of the New Bilibid Prison and it was relocated in building number 7. Okay, formerly Metro Jail of the medium security compound nung nagkaroon ng riot sa maximum security compound. And next is the Davao Penal Colony. So the Davao Penal Colony is located in Tagum, Davao del Norte. This is a prison security compound for medium security prisoner. And it was almost established the same time at and under the same authority that the New Bilibid prison was established. Okay, noong January 21, 1932. Okay. So pareho sila ng New Bilibid prison by virtue of 37 Act number 37 32 and proclamation number 414. Okay. Series of October 7, 1931 yan. As per the recommendation of Governor Dwight Davis. Okay? So ang nagrekomenda ng pagtatay ng Davao Penal Colony is si Governor Dwight Davis. Okay? And also retired General Paulino Santos, the incumbent prisons director noon. Okay? Led the first contingent of prisons that opened the Davao Penal Colony. Okay, ang Davao Penal Colony is about 18 hectares kaluwang. Okay? Parang kagaya din ng Iwaig Penal Colony, meron ding sub-colonies yung Davao Penal Colony, yung Kapalong and Panabo. Okay, and also supervise with the penal supervisor. Okay, kagaya ng Iwahig, meron din silang area na binibigay sa mga nakalayan ng mga colonies. Okay? Na yung mga ayaw na umuwi sa kanila, binibigyan nila ng lupa para sakahin. Yan yung tinatawag nilang Tanglaw Settlement. Okay, the settlement site for released prisoners who no longer wish to return to their homes but choose to remain in Davao as homesteaders. Okay, so yun yung Davao Penal Colony. Okay, so next one is the Sablayan. Okay, the Sablayan Prisons and Penal Farm was established under the proclamation number 72 issued on September 26, 1954, the Sablayan Prisons and Penal Farm in Occidental Mindoro was established. Okay? So dito sa Sablayan Prisons and Penal Farm, okay? It is prisons penal farm is intended for agro-industrial activities. Okay? Doon sa area na 'yon. Okay? Yung Sablayan Prisons Penal Farm, meron din siyang apat na sub-colonies. We have the central sub-colony, we have the Pasugi, we have the Pusog, and we have the Yapang. So lahat ng sub-colony na to is are administered by penal supervisor. Okay? The first contingent, okay, of prison personnel and prisoner were drawn from also to the Iwahig. Okay? So kagaya din ito ng Iwahig. Yung Sublime Prison Penal Farm, mayroong sub-colonies. Okay? That is Sublayan. Okay? And the next one is the Leyte Regional Prison. Okay? Yung Leyte Regional Prison was the last penal facility to be built by the Bureau of Prisons, okay, in Abuyug, Leyte. This was established in on January 16, 1973 on the orders issued under the martial law of the late President Ferdinand E. Marcos. Okay. So ngayon, there are 7 major correctional facilities dito sa bansa natin. Okay? But under Presidential Decree 28 dated October 25, 1972, nakapag-establish sila ng regional prisons. Okay, and converts existing national penal institution into regular prisons and penal farms. Okay. So yan yung history ng correctional institution natin dito sa Pilipinas. Okay? So aside from the existing facilities, we have the other facilities. Pero ang mga ito ay non-operational na. We have the Fort Bonifacio, formerly known as Fort William McKinley, as a military reservation located in Makati, which was established after the Americans came to the Philippines. Naipatayo ito noong andito na yung mga Amerikano sa Pilipinas. The Corregidor Prison, non-operational na rin. So in 1908, during the American regime, some 100 prisoners were transferred from the old Bilibid prison to Corregidor Island to work under military authorities. And the Bontoc prison, it is also non-operational. It was established under Act Number 1876, providing the establishment of prison in Bontoc Mountain Province. So these are the other facilities. But it is already non-operational. Okay, so what are the organizations, the and correction officials and facilities of the Bureau of Correction? So the Bureau of Correction is under the Department of Justice and it is headed by the Director of the Correction. Siya yung pinaka-boss ng Bureau of Correction. Okay, yung director who authorized to exercise command, control, and direction of the following prison facilities and staff offices. So ito na yung 7 existing prisons and penal farm natin. We have the New Bilibid Prison, San Ramon, Iwahig, CIW, Davao Penal Colony, Sablayan Prison Penal Farm, and the later regional prisons. So under lahat sila ng Bureau of Correction. Okay, under the umbrella of the Department of Justice. And also, the Bureau of Corrections staff offices. Ito yung bububuo sa Bureau of Correction. Mga opisina nila doon. We have the Administrative Division, Management Division, General Service Division, Accounting, Supply, Penal Production, Inmate Reception and Education Center. Ito na yung RDC. Budget and Finance Division, the Medical Coordinator's Office, Chaplain Service Office para sa mga religyoso, and Legal Office. Okay, so to sum up, okay, corrections in the Philippines started during pre-colonial times. It was, however, during the Spanish regime when unorganized corrective services was made operational. Okay, the main penitentiary was the Old Bilibid in Manila, which was established in 1847 pursuant to Section 1708 of the Revised Administrative Code, the Royal Decree. In 1865. Okay, when the American took over in 1900s, the Bureau of Prison was created under the Reorganization Act of 1905 or the Act Number 1407 dated November 1, 1905 as an agency under the Department of Commerce and Police. On January 1, 1915, the San Ramon was placed under the auspices of the Bureau of Prison started receiving prisoners from Mindanao. Before the reconstruction of San Ramon prisons, the American established in 1904 the Luhit Penal Settlement. Yan na yung tinatawag nating Iwahig Prisons and Penal Farm ngayon. On a vast reservation of 28,072 hectares. Okay. Other penal colonies was established during the American regime. Okay. On November 27, 1929, the CIW or Correctional Institution for Women was created under Act Number 3579. While the Davao Penal Colony in Southern Mindanao was opened in 1932 under Act Number 3732. Okay. The CIW was founded to provide separate facilities for women offenders. Owing to the increasing number of committals to the old Bilibid prison in Manila. Eh, the Manila, the new Bilibid prisons was established in 1935 in the southern suburb of Muntinlupa, Rizal. And two or more penal institutions would later be established. These were Sublime Prisons Penal Farm in Occidental Mindoro under Proclamation No. 72 issued on September 26, 1954 and later Regional Prisons under Proclamation No. 1101 issued on January 16, 1973. The Bureau of Prison was renamed Bureau of Correction under the new Administrative Code of 1987 issued on November 23, 1987 and Proclamation No. 495 of the President. Okay? And it is one of the attached agencies under the supervision and control of the Department of Justice. Okay? So that's it. And I will share to you this educational quote. Develop a passion for learning. If you do, you will never cease. Yan ang sabi ni Anthony D. Angelo. Thank you and God bless.